this lecture, the methodology for the climatic classification for EAC will be described. The first comprehensive climatic classification system, as shown in the figure, was developed by Waldemar Koppen in 1884. It is based on the concept that native vegetation is the best expression of climate. Climatic zone boundaries were selected with vegetation distribution in mind. Existing classifications of the climatic zones of EAC countries are based on the same concept. Buildings to be low energy and sustainable must be climate responsive. Both buildings and vegetation are best suited to the environment according to climatic parameters such as temperature, humidity, solar radiation, and wind. For vegetation, precipitation has to be added, but they react differently to the same climatic input. Climate classification for EAC, which include 5 countries developed in this project, is based on buildings response to climate and not to vegetation response. To accomplish this task, a methodological approach is developed. This is based on the processing and analysis of climatic data in relation to their impact on building design strategies. Basically, the approach consists of 3 main methods. The first, Hyoni tables. The second is Hyoni bioclimatic chart. And the third one is the data analysis in detail according to their average hourly range, and thereby design strategies were derived. The combination of these 3 methods led to the development of a map of climatic zones based on the effect of the climatic context on building design strategies. Hyoni tables are a set of reference tables used in architecture as a guide to climate appropriate design. They are basically named after architect Karlmann, and these were first published in 1971 by the United Nations Department of Economic and Social Affairs. The figure shows an example of Hyoni tables for an EAC location, thereby derived building design strategies. Hyoni conceived a bioclimatic chart for buildings in 1969 in order to help the designer in the choice of the most appropriate design strategies, starting from local climatic conditions. Hyoni's chart is based on indoor temperature and humidity of the building and suggests design strategies to adapt architecture to climate. The chart uses as a basis a psychrometric chart. Finally, climatic data analysis in detail is carried out according to their average hourly range, thereby deriving design strategies. These figures show the variation of monthly mean values of external air temperature and relative humidity for 2 locations of EAC, Dar es Salaam in Tanzania and Lodwar in Kenya. In conclusion, the combination of these 3 methods led to the development of a map of climatic zones based on the effect of the climatic context on building design strategies. So, the EAC can be divided into 6 bioclimatic zones for energy efficient building design. These are hot humid, hot arid, hot semi-arid savanna, Great Lakes, upland, and finally high upland.